And there are again several possible solutions here, but the maximum number of items that Carol can select is at most 3. And I'll give you one example of this. So, for example, she could decide to invest in the manufacturer, which means she cannot invest in this mining company here. Then she could maybe decide to also invest in this bank, which means she cannot invest in this mining company here. And then she could also choose one of those metals here. So let's say she also decides that she's going to invest in silver. But that means that copper and gold are out of the question. And again, she could have also chosen one of the other possibilities here. But 3 is really the maximum number of items that she can select. So similar to the problem that Bob was working on, this is, of course, a bit of a simplification. So when you're working on real-world finance problems, you usually have constraints that are a bit more complicated. And also, of course, your networks will be much larger. But in essence, that's a sort of problem that you might encounter in financial modeling and optimization, only a simplified version of it.